earn money, even just for food on that day. We just went to church occasionally, like during birthday, Christmas, New Year. And we don't even know how to read the Bible and understand what is written on it. And among all of us siblings, I am only the one given a chance to enter the university because my mother and my two brothers made a decision to send me to the university despite the fact that the family is facing hard situation, provided that after finishing my chosen course, I am obliged to find a job and take place of being the provider of the family. Of course, I was happy then, because it is my dream to finish my study. And for me, this is the only way to uplift my family from poverty. But at the same time, I also felt sad for my family because I know it requires them to make their effort doubled or even tripled to support my needs. My heart and my mind at that time is full of worries, fear, and sometimes I felt I was defeated by the circumstances which I can't find any strength to fight on it. I never thought that I'm about to discover the true meaning of wealth and experience the life being transformed with peace, enjoyment, and satisfaction. So way back 1999, during my university days, I was able to meet one of my dorm mates named Annabelle, and she invited me to attend the service held on their church. Out of curiosity, because I was just a teenager during that time, I went along with her. That was the first time I witnessed the way of worshiping and praising God. I was a kind of confused and quite shocked at that moment because it is different from the way we are doing on the church where I and my family belongs. Because in the Philippines, it is very usual to every born-again Christian church there to do their worship service as what we are experienced during the summer praise, where all people are dancing with full energy, clapping their hands, raising their hand, shouting for joy, and then suddenly when it turns to worship, all hands are lifted high, all eyes are closed while singing, and the others are starting crying while singing. I was just thinking that they are crazy people. Yes, that is. Even the way that the pastor or the sensei is delivering his message to the people. On the church I used to attend before, the priest is very formal. He speaks in a very calm and soft voice. But as I noticed witnessing how the pastor or the sensei delivered this message, I find it somewhat quite different, somewhat different to what I am it is quite different from what I am. I grew up with. So after that experience, I started refusing the invitation from my dorm mate. I made many alibis just to hinder myself from going into church. But I believe that God has a perfect time for every one of us. As it written on Ecclesiastes 3:1, it says there that there is a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heaven. And on verse 11, it says there that He has made all things beautiful in His time. So after many rejected invitations I was made for her, I never expect that one day I will go back again to the church. When the worship service is ongoing, there is a song that captured my attention and touches my heart. And the song goes like this. I know somebody of you knows this. It says, Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way. From the earth to the cross, my death to pay. From the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky, Lord, I lift your name on high. So while singing the song, I felt a certain happiness that came, that I haven't experienced before, as if it came from within. And then suddenly, I felt that there was something freed from me, and a certain security after. Then from that very moment, I know that God is speaking on me, and His Spirit touches my heart and opens my mind. From then, I started to feel excited every time there is a church activity to attend, such as youth fellowship, Bible study, outreach program, especially during Sunday service. I also started reading His Word through the Bible, wherein I learned so many things and answered all my questions and confusions before. It was November 1999 when I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior and decided to follow Him and know Him more. As my relationship with God gets closer each day, He puts burden on my heart for the soul. I wanted to share the way of salvation to everyone who is in need of it. I wanted them to know that everyone needs a salvation because we are all sinners. We are all sinners. Amen. We are all sinners before. And we can't do anything in order to save ourselves from eternal damnation. For it is written in Romans 3:23 that for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. And the one thing to get away from it is to repent and believe to Jesus Christ, accepting Him as our Lord and our Savior. For it is written on Acts 3:19, repent, then turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out. And in John 3:16, everybody knows it. For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. So I love my family, so I had my deepest desire to share the gift I had and I received and let them experience the joy I have found through Jesus Christ. But it came not so easy. I was so rejected by my family many times and started to feel angry and mad on me. My mother warned me that if I'm not stopped on for her, my crazy activity, it's my turn now. I am the one who is crazy. Crazy activity, she will force me to stop from schooling. So I cry to God, kneel on Him and pray, asking for His guidance and protection. Because it is not only my mother, but my whole family is trying to push me away from Him. And the help of God is sufficient to everyone who came to Him with a humble heart. And He answered my prayer. If it is according to His will, it is possible to God answer our prayer. Good thing that the church and the university I am attending is very far from the house of ours. That's why I still attend freely to the church. During the weekend, I went home and spent my days with my family. And during that time, I wasn't aware that my family is observing me in all the things I've done, I do. And every way I speak with them, they are starting noticing that there is something good happening on me. From then, they became considerate on me, for which I know that the doors of heaven have started to open for them. And praise God, I finished my study, I find a job, and in fact, I have my own family now. And my brothers, including my sisters, and many cousins are now Christians and enjoying themselves from serving the Lord with their own ministry. Until now, I was so amazed every time I am remembering all the things He has done for my family. I can't imagine how the Lord changed my life and the life of my brother who was once engaged himself in drinking alcohol, but now serving the Lord together with their own family. And for my mother, who before is a nagger, but now one of the elder of the church, desiring herself to be a blessing for everyone. Brothers and sisters, our life is a gift given to us freely by God. Thanks to God, because until now we are enjoying it in this world. Let this precious gift used by us for honoring Him and giving praise and worship on His name. For it is written, let me close this message by this word of God from 1 Samuel 2:13. It says here, those who honor me, I will honor. But those who despise me will be disdained. God bless us all.